For if we want a lasting peace, then the words of the international community must mean something. Those regimes that break the rules must be held accountable.
I think that you're going to see some significant additional sanctions imposed by the international community, assuming that the Iranians don't change course.
I think that if people want to flirt with Iran, they should take a look at what the consequences might well be for them. And we hope that they will think twice, and we're going to support them if they do.
The Zionist regime and its backers cannot do a damn thing to stop Iran's nuclear work.
Well, as Iran continues its apparent quest for a nuclear bomb, it faces the prospect of new international sanctions and the possibility of military action from Israel, either with or without its allies. The clock is clearly ticking for President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad. The question is, how fast? Once again, our experts tonight, Steve Hayes, senior writer for the Weekly Standard, Mara Liasson, national political correspondent of National Public Radio, syndicated columnist Charles Krauthammer, and retired Major General Robert Scales, Fox News military analyst. Charles.
Well, we lost a year on Iran. The administration had to reinvent the wheel. It had an outstretched hand, and it's been ignored, spit on, humiliated, won. Rejection by Iran to all of the gestures after another, all through this year. Here we are at the end of the year. Nothing is done. The clock is ticking. The Iranians are a year closer to achieving nuclear weapons. And as the Secretary of State said in a clip that we saw earlier, this is a regime that is the biggest perpetrator of terrorism in the world, about to go nuclear. And we are proceeding at a leisurely pace. We may get sanctions into next year. They'll be weak. There'll be lots of negotiations and recalcitrance on the part of the Chinese and the Russians. The sanctions will be useless. All of this is a charade. The real scandal here is that there was a chance to do something important in Iran. There's a revolution happening in the streets today. And it would suit our moral purposes in supporting them and strategic, because the only way to stop a nuke is to have a changing regime. And we stood back. I think that is the scandal of the year. That is a policy we will regret. And to have allowed this opportunity to pass and to not stand up and support the dissidents the way that Reagan did in Eastern Europe in the 80s, I think is something we will regret for a long time.
Mara, a leading dissident cleric died this week and brought tens of thousands of people out to the streets. That was a big deal.
It was a really big deal. Ayatollah Montazeri, I think is how you pronounce his name, he was once the successor to Khomeini. He didn't get that job, but he was very outspoken on his blog about the regime, about the crackdown, about the abuses that the Iranian government is perpetrating on people that they've arrested. And I think that's really unfortunate. On the other hand, the thing that's amazing is that these demonstrations, while they have shrunk in quantity, have become more and more defiant. They haven't gone away. And I think the Obama administration has really struggled to find the right tone to take with this. They didn't want to make it seem like the protesters were a tool of the United States. On the other hand, they have to kind of get right with the people who are in the streets in Iran, because that maybe is the best possible way to get Iran to change its nuclear policy. Other than that, I think we're heading to a policy of containment and deterrence, or maybe we'll have an Israeli military strike.
General, on that last point, right. The Israeli military strike, right. Can Israel take out enough of the nuclear facility, in your judgment, just talking to the folks you talk to really make a difference in Iran?
No. There are few, if any, military options in Iran. First of all, it cannot be invaded. The Zagros Mountains and their heavily defended coastline makes that virtually impossible. They have learned from the Iraqis about how to hide, to bury, to entrench and disperse their nuclear weapons building capability and their delivery systems and their command and control. The best the Israelis could hope for would be to bomb a few centers that might slow down their ability to develop a nuclear weapon, but the international repercussions, both against Israel and against the United States for doing that, would just be enormous.
But if you're Israel and you listen to Mahmoud Ahmadinejad and you see the clock ticking and they are continuing to enrich, at what point do you say we have to act?
They may do it. All I'm saying is the results would be temporary, and the strategic, global strategic consequences of that, I think, would be counterproductive. And I think most military analysts who I've talked to inside the Beltway and in the Pentagon tend to agree with that, but that Israel is a sovereign country. They have one of the most capable air forces in the world, and they certainly have the capability to do some damage. But remember, you can't bomb the knowledge out of nuclear scientists. And if the Iranians want to do this, if they want to build a nuclear weapon, sadly, they're going to do it.
Steve.
Well, I share Charles' fatalism about what is likely to happen here, but I think this actually is an important moment. You've heard the president say for most of the year that the end of the year was going to be the time that he would actually step up. He was going to give the Iranians that much time. He originally said September. He gave him an extension. Now what he does actually will matter in terms of being serious about sanctions. I don't think that they're likely to have much of an effect, but what can he do? Will he actually follow through? Right now you've got his State Department actually telling members of Congress, telling both bodies of Congress, not to pursue sanctions, telling them to sort of dial back. You've also got the president in his possible use of the bully pulpit talking about the Iranian opposition. What he did in June I thought was a disgrace. I'm not sure he can make that right, but he said in his Nobel Peace Prize acceptance speech that he would speak up on behalf of oppressed people. He didn't do that before. He could do that now. But I think the bottom line is you're not going to be able to end the nuclear program in a way that's going to matter. What you need to do is you need to change the regime. You can do it in a number of different ways. I think one of them certainly is enhancing or supporting the Iranian opposition.
Very quickly, Charles, does Israel attack, do you think?
Absolutely. I think the prime minister today is the son of a historian, and he does not want to be the prime minister who presided over the acquisition of a weapons of genocide by a country that appears to be intent, its leadership anyway, on committing it.
Wow. We will look at some other hot spots that could make life difficult for the president after a quick break.